Lo-fi delay from Michael Ibrahim's MI Effects in Sydney, Australia, and it basically takes the PT2399 classic delay chip, which a lot of people are using at the moment, and exploits all of its lo-fi goodnesses. So it's not a delay that's meant to be clean and pristine and digital and lovely and all gorgeous. This is meant to create some crazy warbling sounds, and it begins with the waveform selection up the top. So you've got a triangle waveform and you've got a square waveform. You've got a low-fi mode, which is marked LO, and you've got a high-fi mode, which is marked high. You can run it in trails or you can run it in trails off. 600 milliseconds of delay time. Repeats will go into self-oscillation just at around 1 p.m. on the dial here. And then down below, we've got the modulation. So we've got a modulation rate, we've got modulation depth. Level control mixes the level of the delay signal. It's not a mix control because that dry signal from the guitar is going to be there all the time. And the input control tells you whether or not you're clipping the lo-fi delay, and if you can choose to clip it if you want or back it off and have a nice clean signal. This is a Yamaha RevStar 820, if I'm not mistaken. And I'm running into a very clean Bogner Shiva emulation in UNX effects. At the same time, I also have a super crunch box into the lo-fi delay, which I may engage a little later on. So let's begin firstly with the triangle waveform in low mode. And with only a little bit of depth on the modulation, I'm going to turn the delay level up here a bit. So the difference between low and high and of course if we turn the depth knob up, we're going to get some pretty crazy warbling. Which you can speed up or slow down with the rate knob. And use the low filter to make it darker. Turning the repeats knob up anywhere past 1 o'clock is going to take it into self-oscillation. Gets pretty damn fuzzy. If we go into the square waveform, turning level up a little bit, the more depth I dial in, the stronger that waveform is going to be. But the rate LFO is actually independent to the delay time itself. So that lets me do some very nice chorusing. Now, because we've got the trails mode, it means that I can turn the pedal off and it'll hang on to whatever I've just played beforehand, kind of like a mini looper. So it's a lot of fun. Distortion from the crunch box, obviously. The MIFX lo-fi delay, I'm sure you'll find a cool use for it if you just want to use it as a, you know, standard, very warm sounding delay with some chorusing. You could do that. If you want some square wave mental blippy madness, it'll do that too. Nice one, Michael. See ya.